Thank you so much for the great question. I really love it. And I will answer it from the perspective of being an investor and a scientist and a serial entrepreneur. And so that's why I would like to share with you some data on which I base my investments and activities, but also share with you 5 major trends to see what is actually currently happening right now. And let's pray that whatever fits the humanity better will win. So the global education market is expected to reach, because everything that creates abundance and attracts investors will actually eventually happen, provided the planet plays along. So the market is expected to reach $10 trillion. And it will have to address the population growth in developing markets and the tech skills that are needed in order to grow along those lines. So that means that there will be 350 new postgraduates expected within the next 10 years. I'm talking about what's happening until 2030. So it's in less than a decade. We will also have 800 million graduates. It's all based on the demographic data. And they're most going to come from the African countries, from Asia, and from Latin America. These are the geographies that are going to drive this growth. And I have heard the number 100 million, but I think I heard the number in terms of the students. And I would like to share with you that my numbers, the research that I've done, it talks about 100 million teachers, which makes 1.5 million teachers per annum. So the post-secondary teaching will undergo the biggest transformation, where teachers become mentors and coaches rather than sages. So we are up for massive transformation. So now let me go to the 5 scenarios or waves that are currently happening. One that it doesn't excite me at all is education remains as usual. It is possible, probably in developed worlds that are more conservative. So the traditional institutions remain the trusted cradles of education and learning and most effective vehicle for talent creation. The world economies grow steadily, whereby developing countries suffer from qualified labor supply, which they hope to fill through educated laborers coming from developing countries. And the governments in this scenarios will focus, and the societies focus on improving their local situations and to provide the main source of funding for education. In terms of innovation and technology, the education remains under-digitized as it is right now, which COVID has proven to us. And innovation remains also fragmented and ineffective and at high cost. So venture capitalists will continue to pour money into this industry, nothing significant will happen. So this is one scenario that could happen. I'm based in Germany, and based on what I see right now, I'm not very helpful, but it is a scenario. So the second scenario that or way that could happen is where education is local and regional. So the regions are taking over and will continue to emerge with the intention to dominate regionally. They will build alliances across national borders, sometimes international borders, that will fuel innovation. They will be supported by local governments and private investors. Local hubs will be built, and an exchange will happen. They will share resources. And there will be intra-regional exchanges that will create some jobs, but not the jobs that we actually needed in order to address the numbers that I started with. So the third wave is the global giant educations that are going to take the world over. They will emerge, will consolidate, and become internationally recognized brands. That will bring the world closer by 2030. They will scale fast and achieve industrial power and influence. Free market policies and multinational agreements will have removed the barriers to global trade. That stable geography, geopolitical environments will be created that will nurture this development and the global competition. And intergovernmental organizations will play a major role in international law and security and trade and commerce. So education and tech giants will partner up to gain massive global reach and dominate. That will may help us achieve the goals that we all want to achieve here. And the governments will collaborate with educational giants in order to ensure that education is being driven and also regulated, which is mandatory. And it will occur, will have to occur. And so the data coming from educators will feed into regulators and inform their decisions. So that is a development that is currently happening. Education will be fully personalized, and research and development will stay with the global education. So that's the third wave. The fourth wave that is actually happening is a peer-to-peer education that is based on trust, and that's where technology will play a major role because the peer-to-peer economy will facilitate that and will become mainstream. However, that presupposes that smartphones will provide the internet access necessary in order to provide that kind of education, and we'll have to gain 80% of market penetration. So there will be ubiquitous connectivity, which will lead to declining transaction costs, making everything cheaper, and will also increase peer-to-peer goods exchange. So the learners themselves will determine what they learn, when they learn, how they learn. And we'll collect micro-credentials that Ralph mentioned before. From a large number, and again, large number, different number of education providers. And the credentials themselves will be protected by blockchain technology, which is the foundation of the peer-to-peer economy. So the post-secondary and skilled trade learning sectors become the dominant online learning platform. And the teacher's IP, intellectual profit, property of the teachers, will be protected by blockchain, of course. And of course, the regulators will struggle to define their own role in this peer-to-peer economy that like Remus was talking about. So the regulators need to find a room that they were gonna lose the power along that unless they get involved early enough. So the fifth wave, which is, I'm an AI major. I studied artificial intelligence 40 years ago. That's how old I am. Is the fifth wave, which is the AI revolution. And that's where the labor force is reduced in developing countries, in developed countries, as we know, it's happening. And the role of AI will be to drive productivity and push the overall economic growth while reducing the cost significantly. And so the data collected by AI will be channeled to regulators whose key focus will be to data security. And so AI technology will have delivered significant economic benefit to most countries. It will disrupt traditional education, which is currently actually happening. And it drives AI-based learning through virtual teachers, virtual mentors, augmented education. AI will design education, restructure learning, and provide the feedback, and also decide when to bring in human teachers. So I will stop here, and we can discuss further these waves during the Q&A session. Thank you.